Hello, my name is Scott Felber from the NX product marketing team. Today, we're going to look at tips and tricks around the NX Molded Part Designer. NX Molded Part Designer is a streamlined application to help you design plastic injection molded parts quickly and easily and according to your company and industry best standards. Let's go ahead now and take a look at some of the features of this new product. The first thing you'll notice in molded part design is you have preferences for either the moldability or the feature validation to what values you want it to be for it to be a good design that you can make. These can be set for each company's individual needs. Let's take a look now at some of the rich features we can create, starting with the mounting boss. As you see in the command, it prompts the users for the needed inputs and all the values needed. In addition to just the values, there's also legends to help you be able to see what these values actually are and where they are on the part. So in this case, we're just going to pick two points around this hole here, and we'll go ahead and create those mounting bosses in those locations with the values we have selected. Very simple, very easy. Next thing we want to do is create a couple of snap clips up around this existing hole. Again, you'll notice some of the same features we had before with the legends and the values. The thing here with the snap joints is you need to give it also a direction as to which way you want the clip to point. So in this case, we're just going to go ahead and create them one at a time because we want them opposing each other over this open gap. So we'll go ahead now and just create these two snap joints just like that. But the one thing we see here in the snap joint menu is the ability to create pockets. What happens if I put a snap joint in the middle of a solid area? What I want to do here is just demonstrate that I can include a pocket around that snap joint to be able to have it snap to the other part. So I go ahead, and similar to what I did before, I create the point I wanted in the values, and now I can see that I have a pocket directly through my part. Let's step ahead now and look at drafting some of the faces along this area here. We have what we call the recommended draft angle, where it will notice what you have picked and say these are the draft angles you want to use. But we notice here it didn't give me one value because I did not have any material selected to the part. Again, that validation. So as I go ahead and I assign material to the part, and now I go ahead and draft those faces and ask for a recommended draft angle, I just get one minimum draft angle because I have material assigned. Now that the part's been drafted there, we have some features on it, let's go ahead now and start some of that validation that we talked about early on. First, we'll look at the moldability validation. We can see we have no undercuts here, which is a good idea, which is a good to have. Also, we can go ahead and see piece by piece where these thick or thin walls are. Zoom in those areas and see if we may or may not need to take action there, as we saw there that those parts were all within warning levels, not red levels. Now we'll go ahead and look at some of the features. A couple of them come up yellow, a couple of them come up red. So let's go ahead now, and if we edit one, what it does, it brings the menu up that was used to create that particular feature, and we can expand that feature down as it's highlighted in the screen and find out exactly what values it is. In this case, we just want to look at some of the ribs and why they failed, because we didn't have a hint from the top. We had a hint down in because there was no radius at the base. What we're going to do now is go back into that area we drafted before and create some radiuses around the base of that feature. And when we do that, you'll notice that all of our rib features go from red to yellow in that area. There's still a couple other ones, rib one in particular, that needs to be addressed down the road. But we can now determine what we need and not need to fix moving forward. One of the coolest features now, at the end, we want to put a rectangular groove around our entire part. The rectangular groove command is very simple to use. We just pick one edge, and it will follow that edge all around all its tangent spots to go ahead and create that groove. So we go ahead now, pick one edge, and we have the entire groove picked. As we walk around the groove, it followed everything along but stopped here. These edges weren't tangent, they were squared off. So what I want to do now is I want to go back before I apply that, apply some blends to that area, and then reapply that groove. And you can see now it continues to travel along that tangent path. But I missed one more edge. So now I just quickly edit the blend that I created all the other ones with, put a blend right there. And now when I go ahead and okay that, everything updates and I get that groove to come all the way around my part. I hope you enjoyed this tips and tricks. I hope if you're in the plastic part design business that you take a serious look at the NX Molded Part Designer, and thank you for your time.